How are we doing today? This is Marcel with LATICRETE Tech Service. Today I'm going to be going over some tips for hot weather tiling and grouting. This information is going to essentially be pulled from our TDS Technical Data Sheet 176, which you can always find on our website, laticrete.com, by going to Supports and Downloads, then choosing Technical Data Sheets, and in there you're going to find a wealth of knowledge, tons of documents to go over many, many different things that you might face in a job, industry standards, FAQs, you name it. So let's get into it. Conventional Portland cement tile setting beds, thinset mortars, cement plasters, and stuccos are often permanently damaged when subject to hot, dry temperatures or desert climates immediately after installation. Hot temperatures remove the water content in the mortar required for the Portland cement hydration, curing, and strength development. In addition, rapid drying often causes mortar to crack, crumble, and lose bond. Waterproofing membranes, anti-fracture membranes, epoxy adhesives, and grouts, pretty much any other product that you're going to use in a hot temp will be affected by hot working temperatures. One of the main problems that people are going to experience on the site is that it's flash setting or is a reduced working time. We'll get the call often that the product is failing when in actuality it's the environment that you're installing the product in that's making it not perform correctly. It is important to note that the surface temperature is more important than the air temperature in these types of installs. Therefore, monitoring the surface temp of the installation before proceeding is important. Something as simple as a little heat gun. These are pretty cheap at your big box stores. You shoot this at the surface, it's going to tell you the temperature. It's an easy, cheap way to make sure that you're okay within the installation parameters. Very simple rule to follow when doing these types of high temp installs is the 18 degree rule. For every 18 degrees above 70 degrees, which is essentially where most of these products are tested at, all their performance standards are based on, for every 18 degrees over that temperature, it's going to take those products half as long to cure. So for example, if you have a product that has a 60 minute working time, for 18 degrees over 70, you're looking at 30 minutes. Imagine on a 100 degree day what that's going to do to your product. Okay, so again, make sure the environment's right for the product that you're using. This is where the use of premium polymer fortified adhesive mortars, such as like 254 platinum, 257 titanium, and products like our MVIS high bond veneer mortar are going to be advantageous for you. Other products come to mind, Multimax Light, 3701 fortified mortar bed, MVIS veneer mortar, MVIS lightweight mortar. All these types of things are going to help you in these types of temperatures. Are going to allow these installations to be made at higher temps because they have longer working properties and can be made in temperatures as high as 90 degrees Fahrenheit under normal circumstances. Long story short, LATICRETE premium polymer fortified mortars are affected more slowly by high temperatures and thermal shock after placement and eliminate the need for wet curing. Very important to note, rapid setting materials will provide far greater challenges when working in high temperatures and should be used with caution. Again, keeping in mind that 18 degree rule. All right, so how do we combat these high temp installs, right? Most jobs aren't going to shut down for 2 months because it's hot outside. So here's some general tips for working these hot temperatures. Starts at the beginning. For best results, always ship and store insulation materials between 40 and 90 degrees to extend the shelf life and working time. Do not store these products in direct sunlight. If insulation materials are too warm, they should be cooled to the specified temperature range for that specific product. So get them out of, say, the hot Connex box on the job site. Let them acclimate inside somewhere, cool them down before you start using them. Another good tip is to dampen or wet down the substrate to not only clean the area, but to lower the temperature and lower the absorption rate of the substrate. A lot of times if these surfaces are hot, combined with the heat and the dryness of the substrate, it's going to suck the water right out of that material, again, decreasing the performance of the product you're installing. So a good technique is to saturate that surface. You don't want it soaking wet. You do want to sweep off the puddles. A good tool most of the time is going to just be a simple pump sprayer, fill it with water, get a nice mist on there. Again, that's going to cool that surface down and also prevent it from sucking that moisture right out of the product as you're using it. This step will extend the working time of the insulation materials. Another good tip is to use cool or cold water to mix the mortars. Never use hot or warm water when mixing any tile insulation materials. It's often a good idea due to the rapid rate of moisture loss and Portland cement dehydration at temperatures above 90 to cover these insulations with polyethylene sheeting for 1 to 2 days to allow curing at a more normal rate. Another great tip is going to be to tent off or provide shade when working in direct sunlight. So as you can see here, it might add a little work to the beginning of the job, but on a hot weather tile job, this prep work up front is going to make the actual install and quality of an install much better on the back end. And finally, a surefire way to combat these high temp problems is to simply work during cooler periods of the day. Get started earlier in the morning, maybe get started after the sun starts to go down if it's a project where it has night shifts. These simple steps are going to help to ease your installation and quality of your install exponentially. I hope this information was helpful and have a great day.